Welcome back, students. In today's session, we'll discuss the process of oogenesis. So, you already know that the first event, reproductive event, which takes place in sexual reproduction, that is gametogenesis. There are two types of gametogenesis. One is spermatogenesis, and the other one is oogenesis. So, in the last session, we discussed the process of spermatogenesis. You already know that the formation of haploid male gamete is called spermatogenesis. It takes place within the seminiferous tubules under the influence of two pituitary hormones. One is FSH and the one is LH. The second type of gametogenesis is oogenesis. The process of formation of female haploid gamete or oom is called oogenesis. Where it takes place? Within the follicular cells of the ovary? When it takes place? It takes place, or the oogenesis process is initiated during fetal developmental stages and completes after attaining puberty. So let us start with the oogenesis. So, one of the contrasting difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis is the spermatogenesis process starts after attaining sexual maturity, whereas the oogenesis process starts during fetal life and completes after attaining sexual maturity. This is one contrasting difference. The second contrasting difference, the process of spermatogenesis completes in two steps. One is formation of spermatids. The second one is spermiogenesis. Whereas the process of oogenesis completes in a single step, and which includes three phases. One is a multiplication phase, growth phase, maturation phase. And you remember one thing, the multiplication phase is restricted to the fetal life. So after the birth, growth phase takes place. After attaining puberty, maturation phase takes place. So you already know that the ovary is lined by germinal epithelium. So the germinal epithelium is made up of a special type of cells, epithelial cells, called cuboidal epithelial cells. Okay, and the cuboidal epithelial cells possesses female germ cells or oogonial cells. At the time of fetal life or during fetal life, the oogonial cells undergo repeated mitotic division. That is, female primordial germ cells undergo repeated mitotic division that results in formation of egg mother cells or oogonium. And this phase, this phase we called as a multiplication phase and restricted to the fetal life. You remember one thing, no more oogonia or egg mother cells are added after the birth. That means the multiplication in oogenesis, the multiplication process is restricted to the fetal life. So soon after the birth, these oogonial cells or oogonia enters into the prophase 1 stage of the meiotic division, but temporarily arrested at this stage, and such cells are called primary oocyte. And soon after the birth, these primary oocyte encloses, accumulates nutrients and become highly enlarged differentiated cell, and that cell we called as a primary oocyte, which is diploid in nature, and this phase we call it as a growth phase. And you remember, once the primary oocytes are formed, these primary oocyte is surrounded by a layer of granulosa cells. Such cells are called, or such differentiated cells are called primary follicle. So in between birth and puberty, the primary follicles are transformed into secondary follicles, are transformed into tertiary follicle. After attaining puberty, the tertiary follicles are transformed into graafian follicle or matured follicle, and within the follicular cells the oogenesis process completes. So one contrasting difference between primary follicle and secondary follicle is the primary follicle is surrounded by a layer of granulosa cells. I'll discuss later. Maturation phase I'll discuss later. So the primary follicles are surrounded by a layer of granulosa cell, and such cells are called primary follicles. Or the primary oocyte gets surrounded by a single layer of granulosa cells is called primary follicles. So these follicles, or a large number of primary follicles, get degenerated from the phase from birth to puberty. So in between birth and puberty, the primary follicles get degenerated by the process called follicular atresia. Therefore, at puberty, around 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles left in each ovary. That means, so both ovaries consist of approximately around 1,60,000 of primary follicles. And these primary follicles get differentiated into or transformed into secondary follicle. The secondary follicles, the primary oocyte is surrounded by more layer of granulosa cells. Look at here. The primary follicle, a primary oocyte surrounded by a layer of granulosa cells, whereas in secondary follicles, the primary oocyte is surrounded by, a more layer of granulosa cells. Soon after the formation of secondary follicles, the secondary follicles transformed into tertiary follicle, and which is characterized by a fluid filled cavity, and that fluid filled cavity is called antrum. So one contrasting difference between the secondary follicle and tertiary follicle is the tertiary follicle possesses a fluid filled cavity, and that cavity is called as an antrum, and this antrum is filled with a fluid material, and that fluid material is called liquor folliculi. And the theca layers, there are two theca layers, theca interna and theca externa, organized into outer theca externa and theca interna. At this stage, the primary oocyte within the tertiary follicle grow in size, completes first meiotic division. That means after attaining puberty, the meiosis process is reinitiated. So after the birth, primary oocyte is temporarily arrested in prophase 1 stage. After attaining puberty, the primary oocytes completes first meiotic division and differentiate into secondary oocyte and first polar body. You remember one thing, the meiosis 1 is a reductional division. As a result of this, you find the chromosome numbers are reduced to half one. The second one, during the process of oogenesis, two unequal cytokinesis takes place. As a result of this, two unequal sized cells are produced. The larger one is called haploid secondary oocyte and the smaller one is called a first polar body. So the primary oocyte, okay, after attaining puberty, it completes first meiotic division. As a result of this, two unequal sized cells are produced. The larger one is called a secondary oocyte, haploid secondary oocyte, and the smaller one is called a first polar body. And look at here, the secondary oocyte completes second meiotic division when it comes in a contact with a male gamete. So when it comes in a contact with the male gamete, it completes second meiotic division. Again, it will produce two unequal sized cells. The larger one is called ootid, and the smaller one is called a second polar body. And you remember, these polar bodies does not play any role in the process of fertilization. Immediately they are produced and they get degenerated. At the end of oogenesis, from single primary oocyte, three polar bodies and one ova is produced, and these three polar bodies get degenerated. And one oom is fertilizes with a sperm that results in formation of diploid zygote. And this phase we called as a maturation phase, and this maturation phase takes place after attaining puberty. So this completes the oogenesis process. Next, we'll move to the next very important, that will be asked for 5 marks question, the difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. The first difference is the spermatogenesis is a formation of haploid male gamete, whereas oogenesis is a formation of a female haploid gamete. So second difference, the spermatogenesis process takes place in the testes or male gonad, whereas oogenesis process takes place in the female gonad, that is ovary. The second difference. Third difference, the primary spermatocyte does not accumulate yolk during growth phase. So you already know that yolk is a reserved food material, and this yolk is produced by the process called vitellogenesis. Vitellogenesis means the formation of yolk is called vitellogenesis, that is absent in case of spermatogenesis. Whereas during the process of oogenesis, the primary oocyte accumulates reserved food material in the form of yolk during growth phase, and in non-mammalian eggs. That means in case of human egg is alacetal, yolk is completely absent. That means in case of human egg, apart from human eggs, the egg-laying mammals where the vitellogenesis process takes place. And come back to the fourth difference. At the end of first meiotic division and second meiotic division, meiotic division takes place within the seminiferous tubules. So first meiotic division and second meiotic division takes place within the seminiferous tubules, whereas in the process of oogenesis, the first meiotic division is completed in the follicular cells just before the ovulation. So ovulation means the release of secondary oocyte from the graafian follicle of the ovary is called ovulation, and which takes place exactly 14th day of menstrual cycle. So first meiotic division takes place within the follicular cells, whereas second meiotic division takes place after ovulation, that is outside the ovary but within the fallopian tube. Then fifth difference, each primary spermatocyte undergo first meiotic division, resulting formation of two haploid equal sized secondary spermatocyte, and these two secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division, produce four equal sized non-motile, non-functional spermatids. Whereas during the process of oogenesis, each primary oocyte undergoes first meiotic division, resulting in the formation of unequal haploid cell. The larger one is called a secondary oocyte and the smaller one is called a first polar body. That means during the process of oogenesis, the polar bodies are produced, and during the process of spermatogenesis, polar bodies are not produced. Is that it? At the end of spermatogenesis, the next difference, okay, seventh one. At the end of spermatogenesis, from single primary spermatocyte, four haploid sperms are produced. Whereas during the process of oogenesis, from single primary oocyte, only one haploid oa is produced. Then fourth one. Look at here, each primary site gives rise to four haploid spermatids or sperms. Each primary oocyte gives rise to one haploid, haploid fertilizable oa, and three polar bodies. So these are the differences between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. So this completes the process of gametogenesis. In the next class, next session, we'll discuss the menstrual cycle. Thank you.